Hello student, up to now we have completed two video related to the DVD player. So now in this video we are going to learn some important functions. So starting with our first topic, that is optical pickup unit. As you can see on your screen, this is the diagram of optical pickup unit. It consists of DVD discs, laser beam and photodiode array unit. So the function of optical pickup unit is to extract data from DVD using laser beam and then converted the reflected laser beam signal into the radio frequency signal using photodiode array. So optical pickup unit is mounted on an arm placed under the disc, along which the pickup head can move to follow the track or read the different tracks. So the student, main important function of optical pickup unit is to read the data from disc. For that we required a laser beam, and that laser beam is generated by using the diode, and after reflecting the light beam it is going to convert into the electrical signal by using the photodiode array. So the reflected signal contains A, B, C, D outputs, that is one for radio frequency signal, another is for focusing control signals, another is for tracking signals, and lastly with the control signals. So after demodulating the radio frequency signal, audio and video signals we get. Here, this is the basic component assembly of optical pickup unit. As I am shown here, this is the laser diode that is used to generate that light beam, and this light beam can be passed through some collimator lens, beam splitter circuit, objective lens, and this is the DVD. So gallium arsenide diode is used to generate that light beam, and it is passed through lenses, collimation lens, objective lens and beam splitter. Its function is to read the data. Beam pass through lenses and beam splitter towards the discs. The reflected beam from the DVD pass through photodiode arrays. So the function of photodiode arrays is used to convert the reflected light beam into the electrical signal. Again, the function of beam splitter, it is used to convert the reflected light beam signal to the 90 degree towards the photodiode. So the main agenda or main function of this unit is to read the data or extract the data from the DVD. For that purpose, we have required the laser beam and reflected light beam. Purpose, we required a photodiode current. DVD playback process. So, students, on this topic, some 4 hours question may be asked. Describe the block diagram of DVD playback process. Shown here diagram of DVD playback process. It consists of rotating DVD disc mechanism, optical pickup head, focusing and tracking and survey controls. After decoding, we convert that audio and video signals, memory, video signal for the television, audio signal also for the television, some user interface. So the student, pickup head is used to read the data on the disk. The decoded signal from photodiode gives audio and video signal output. Beam focus and control by the microprocessor. And the memory is required for processing and normal routing operation of the DVD player. Some important questions may be asked on this topic. What are the different types of lens present in DVD players? So, lens is the heart of the DVD player unit. If the lens unit or lens assembly is failed, then we cannot read the data from the DVDs. So we cannot playback the data from the DVDs. So lenses are collimation lens, we also called as a collimator lens, concave lens, objective lens, and cylindrical lens. First is collimation lens. This collimation lens is used to produce completely parallel beam of laser. This lens together with the objective lens is used to focus the laser beam onto the disc surface. Concave lens, in the single beam linear optical block assembly, this concave lens is used to reflect the beam from the disc surface and gives into the photodiode arrays. This lens is mainly used to improve the sensitivity of the photodiode arrays. Objective lens. It is used to focus the laser beam on the disc surface and to receive the reflected beam. This beam is moved up and down to achieve the focus of the laser beam on the disc surface. Some important driver motors are used in the DVD players, and that are tri-loading motors, slit feed motors, spindle, discs or turnable motors. First is tri or cartridge motor. When we open or close the switch on front panel of the DVD player, then the cartridge motor moves the DVD tri in and out for loading and uploading of the DVD purpose. Such function of this motor used to push out or eject as well as read the DVD tray. Purpose, tray cartridge motor. Feed motors. This motor moves the optical pickup unit from center to the outer edge of the disc on sliding rod. It is used to move the optical pickup unit. Spindle motors. A driver motor spins the discs, and this driver motor precisely controlled by the rotation between 200 to the 500 RPM. Feed motor. This motor moves the optical pickup unit from center to the outer edge of the disc. So this motor keeps the objective lens constantly in the line with the center of the optical axis. Feed motor may be used for two important functions. One would be the forward purpose, another would be the reverse mode operation purpose. Some advantages of the DVDs: it having larger storing capacities, like 4.7 to the maximum 17 GB. Sound and picture quality is excellent due to the MPEG formats. DVD having higher sampling rate as compared to the CD. Disadvantage: DVD did not work in the CVT drives. They can be easily damaged by breaking or scratching. Current player cannot use the reverse at the normal speed. It doesn't fully support to the HD TV. These are the some disadvantage. My dear student, if you don't have DVDs, then important point is that you can easily connect your mobile to the DVD player by using two methods: one by using Bluetooth module, another by using aux cable. These are the again development in the DVD players. Here we complete all the topics of DVD players. I hope you understand something new. If you have any questions, please ask. Thank you for watching.